Madame Molly Scott-Cutter. 2 minutes, thank you, please.
First it was Harvey, the wettest hurricane ever recorded, that flooded Houston in hours. Then Irma, with record-breaking winds of 185 miles per hour. Yet as the eye of the storm moved through the Caribbean and Florida, politicians, the media and others closed their eyes in order to protect their interests. Their priority, maintaining the status quo of turbo capitalism, a system that requires perpetual growth and in varying degrees climate change denial. Indeed, when my colleague Caroline Lucas MP made the link between Hurricane Irma and climate change to UK Minister Alan Duncan, he said she lacked humanity. When we learned that Mr. Duncan had previously pocketed thousands of pounds working for an oil company, it all of a sudden became clear why he had made such an absurd snipe. After all, Caroline Lucas was simply respecting the science, that a warmer world with warmer oceans leads to greater evaporation, which in turn fuels more destructive storms. That's no more than others have done. From Gaston Brown, leader of the devastated Antigua and Barbuda, through to President Macron of France and Pope Francis. I say it is politicians who defend the interests of fossil fuel industries who lack humanity. Equally inhumane is the fact that $5 trillion is thrown at the fossil fuel industry each year in subsidies. That's 6.5% of global GDP, supporting the dirty economy of the past, when we should be investing it in the clean, green economy of the future. The humane thing to do is to act in the interests of those whose lives are now being torn apart by climate breakdown, especially those living in low-lying territories and in the path of storms, as well as millions of others across the globe, especially those from the poorest communities. This demands a new ethics, politics, and a new economic model.
Thank you, Rajidit. Madame Scott-Cutter. And now...